Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to bind local Lisp data that has hierarchical relationships and service URLs from a remote server to the Syncfusion Blazor TreeView. I am going to show you how to bind data to the Blazor TreeView in a Blazor WebAssembly application. If you want to know more about Blazor WebAssembly apps and how to add Syncfusion components to them, then you can watch the video titled Create a Blazor WebAssembly app and add Syncfusion Blazor components, which I have shared in the YouTube card. First, I will open my existing Blazor WebAssembly app. I have already installed the Syncfusion Blazor package. Then I registered the Syncfusion Blazor service with a valid trial license and referenced the CSS file from the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. To work with Blazor TreeView in the index component, I have included the Syncfusion Blazor navigation namespace. I have added Syncfusion Blazor TreeView with the TreeView field settings tag, along with the properties data source to bind data, ID mapping to identify the nodes uniquely, parent ID mapping to indicate the parent node for that item. The ID and parent ID were configured since the data source assigned here is a self-referential type, that is flat data. I added the hasChildren property and set the value to hasSubfolders so that it sets whether a node has subnodes or not. hasSubfolders has the value true if it is a parent node, otherwise it is a leaf node. I have added the text property and set the value folder name, which contains the display text for the nodes. I have set the expanded property with the value expanded so that the tree view will render in expanded state at initial load. Also, I have set the t value property with mail item to understand data source type. I have enabled the show checkbox property to show checkboxes for each tree node. This way, I can check more than one node in the tree view without affecting the UI's appearance. I have enabled editing using the allow editing property and enabled multiple node selection using the allow multi selection property. I have enabled drag and drop using the allow drag and drop property. Here in the onInitialized method, I have added mail item to the myFolder list object. You will notice that the data is flat data. Now I run the project. You can see the tree view with flat data bound to it and a checkbox in each node. Let me configure the tree view with hierarchical data. I add a new property of type list of mail item subfolders so that I can add child nodes to a node. I add a variable of object type child and set the value to subfolders so that I can bind this value to tree view to identify the child field. I remove the properties parent ID and has subfolders since they are not applicable for hierarchical data. In the onInitialized method, let me remove the existing code and add hierarchical data. Here, I have created two parent nodes with child nodes and added those nodes to the myFolder object. In the TreeView field settings tag, I remove the parent ID and hasChildren properties since these are not applicable for hierarchical data. Next, I add the child property and set the value child so that the TreeView can understand the property child holds the child nodes. I save the file and run the application. You can see the tree view loaded with hierarchical data with two parents with their child nodes. Now, let's look at binding a service URL from a remote server to the tree view. I need to make use of the Data Manager component to access the online data service. Data Manager is a Syncfusion component that acts as a gateway and interacts with both local and remote data sources. By default, the tree view will load remote data on demand when you expand the parent nodes. In the mail item class, I remove the existing field name and add the needed fields with respect to the remote data. I remove the other code in the code directive. To access the data manager, I use the namespace Syncfusion Blazor data. In the tree view field settings tag, I add the SF data manager tag. To interact with a remote data source, I provide the endpoint URL in the data manager with a valid service URL. I set the adapter with a OData V4 adapter as the service URL passed to the data manager is created based on OData standards. I set the cross-domain property to true so that the data manager can understand the current Blazor application and remote service are of different domains. In the TreeView field settings tag, I remove the data source property and child property since we are going to load self-referential remote data. I add the t value and set the value mail item so that TreeView can understand the data type of the remote data. I set the ID property with the value employee ID and set the as children property with the employee ID. I also set the text property with the value first name. I add the query property and set new query string to select 5 employee IDs, names, and titles. The query we add in this property will be executed by the tree view and populate the data at runtime. To load the child data, I add the tree view field child tag and copy and paste the same settings from the tree view field settings tag. This is because the child nodes will be loaded on demand with their own data manager instance. Here, I change the query to fetch 5 order IDs, employee IDs, and chip names. I change the ID with value order ID. I change the asChildren property to parent ID and maintain the same value of employee ID. This way, the tree view can understand the parent-child relationship while loading data on demand. I change the text to ship name so that I can see the ship names based on the employee who took the order. I run the application. You can see the tree view with remote data loaded in it. I click the expand button and it loads the child nodes on demand. Finally, let me summarize the main points. I explained the steps to bind list data with hierarchical relationships and service URLs from a remote server to the Syncfusion Blazor TreeView. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the video description below. You can also check if you are eligible for our community license, which gives you a free license key to use our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to get notifications about new videos. Thanks for watching.